Hello everyone, welcome to edupediaworld.com. This is your video lecturer Vomika Soni, and in the current video lecture I will explain you all about blood clotting. In my previous video lecture I have already discussed about platelets and functions of blood. For all those who have not seen my previous video lecture, I strongly recommend you all to do so. So let's begin the current video lecture. See, most people get cuts and scraps from time to time, yet we do not bleed to death because blood contains a self-sealing material that plugs leaks. The sealant is always present in an inactive form. The inactive form is also known as fibrinogen. A clot forms only when this plasma protein is converted to its active form known as fibrin. Fibrin aggregates into threads that form the framework of the clot. See, the process of clot formation at the site of blood loss from the body is called clotting or coagulation. Blood clotting or coagulation involves a series of chemical reactions which culminate in the formation of fibrin threads. Clotting of blood prevents further loss of blood and entry of pathogenic microorganisms. Blood clotting involves participation of many substances like calcium ions, commonly known as clotting factors or coagulation factors. See, the entire clotting process can be divided into four stages. The first stage is formation of enzyme thrombokinase, which is also known as thromboplastin, by the injured tissue cells and the platelets. Here you can see that because of the injured tissue cells, the thromboplastin, the enzyme, is formed. The next stage is thrombokinase and calcium ion convert the plasma protein prothrombin into enzyme thrombin. Here you can see that the prothrombin is converted into thrombin in the presence of thromboplastin and the calcium ions. In stage 3, the enzyme thrombin converts soluble fibrinogen formed by the liver into insoluble fibrin. As you can see in this figure, fibrinogen is converted to fibrin in the presence of thrombin, which is produced by liver. See, fibrin is a solid substance that forms thread. These microscopic threads of fibrin are sticky and form a network at the wound. See, the last stage of blood clotting is the stage in which the blood cells get entangled in the mesh and together settle down as a clot or thrombus. Here you can see that the blood clot is formed. So these were the four stages of blood clotting. See, clotting within an intact blood vessel, usually a vein, is called thrombosis. The clot may dissolve spontaneously. Next, I will discuss about hemophilia. Hemophilia is an inherited blood disorder. Male children can inherit it from their mothers. The blood of a hemophilic clots very slowly or not at all. See, either the hemophilic has too few platelets or the platelets cannot produce the chemical which causes fibrinogen to change into fibrin. There are some facts related to clotting. Vitamin K is required for the formation of prothrombin. Next, to avoid clotting of blood stored in blood bank, sodium oxalate or sodium citrate is added. Anticoagulants are substances which, when mixed with blood, prevent clotting. So sodium oxalate and sodium citrate are anticoagulants that are added in order to avoid clotting of the blood. So this was all about today's video lecture. Hope you have enjoyed the video lecture and understood the concept properly. In my upcoming video lecture, I will further discuss about blood groups and blood transfusion. Till then, keep watching to the videos of edupediaworld.com. Have a wonderful day ahead.